There's a letter here coming from Mayor Kapil. May sinasabi po siya ditong sinisiraan daw siya ni Pyra Lucas. Toto Kausing. Mayroon siyang pag-aaring 5 milyon. Ah, nakakatanggap siya ng 5 milyong piso buwan-buwan. Mayroon siyang mga luxurious cars and mansions which he is denying through this letter. May I know if we have information whether the DILG has initiated already a lifestyle check on Mayor Kapil?
I also represented the investigation for the Bamban Tarlac for Mayor Alice Guo, Your Honor.
May I respectfully move, Mr. Chair, that we invite Pyra Lucas and Toto Kausi.
Hindi kayo nag-initiate ng lifestyle check kay ano? Kay Mayor Kapil.
Ngunit sa kasalukuyan po, ang pinokus lang po ng aming task force ay ang magiging mga posibleng administrative liability ng ating butihing mayor mula sa po.
Go ahead, Congresswoman Luistro.
There's a letter here coming from Mayor Kapil. May sinasabi po siya ditong sinisiraan daw siya ni Pyra Lucas, Toto Kausing. Allegedly, it is being alleged na mayroon siyang pag-aaring 5 milyon. Ah, nakakatanggap siya ng 5 milyong piso buwan-buwan. Mayroon siyang mga luxurious cars and mansions which he is denying through this letter. I became curious, Mr. Chair. And may I ask Paok, kayo po ba ang tamang agency para mag-initiate ng lifestyle check to check on the veracity of the allegations contained on the letter of Mayor Kapil?
Hindi po, ma'am. May DILG po para tumingin po sa kaso.
Mr. Chair?
Yes,
may I know if we have information whether the DILG has initiated already a lifestyle check on Mayor Kapil in the face of the allegations contained in his own letter?
Well, in the last hearing, we have asked Mayor Kapil if he's willing to undergo a lifestyle check. And he said yes. And we tasked the proper agencies including DILG and AMLAC, no? To start the process of that lifestyle check. So maybe we can ask, wala tayong DILG. ASEC, Racho, can you comment
on the... Good afternoon, Mr. Chair, and good afternoon to the members of the committee.
Can you comment on the query of Congresswoman Luistro?
Sir, may I refer you to the head of the task force na binuo po ng DILG, si Atty. Landay po.
I will wait. So you have created a task force?
Yes, sir. To look on this matter, sir. Nasa kanya po yung details. She's here now, sir.
What's the name of the person?
Atty. Alday po.
Atty.
Alday po.
Okay.
Alday.
Ma'am, dito kayo siya. Sit here. Oh, yan. Diyan na lang. Palit na lang kayo. Ah, babae pala. Ah, lalaki pala. Please state your name and your position, please.
Magandang hapon po, Honorable Chair, Honorable Members of the Committee and our research speakers here today. I am Attorney Alday from the Department of the Interior and Local Government. I am the head of the task force for Porac Tarlac, Porac Pampanga, Your Honor. I also represented the investigation for the Bamban Tarlac for Mayor Alice Guo, Your Honor.
There's a query by Congresswoman Luistro. If you have started and initiated the lifestyle check of Mayor Kapil, because Mayor anyway, kay Alice Go naman, established na po yung 29 accounts niya and the 29 billion transactions, no, bank transactions that we have seen, no. As a matter of fact, galing yun sa Court of Appeals sa na na-file na po ng AMLAC. So with regard to that, to that query kay Mayor Kapil, have you started it?
Yeah, Honorable Chair, as for the lifestyle check, Your Honor, no, ang finocus lang po ng DILG sa aming investigasyon, Your Honor, is if ever ang munisipyo po ng Porac Tarlac ay nakapag-release ng mga permits na may kulang. Kung kunyari po, kung sila po ay nag-release ng business permit, and may mga pagkukulang po sa dokumento na isubmit ang mga POGO na nasa kanilang lugar, doon po ay magkakaroon po sila ng mga administrative liabilities. Wait. Ang aming investigasyon po ay nag-focus lang po sa administrative liabilities, hindi po sa lifestyle check, Your Honor.
So hindi kayo nag-initiate ng lifestyle check kay ano, kay Mayor Capil?
Your Honor,
wherein in the last hearing he manifested that is willing to sign any waiver for the opening of his accounts and his properties, where it was not considered by the task force that you created, that he manifested here in this hearing that he was willing to open his all of his accounts.
As Your Honor,
kasi baka mamaya may makita kayo doon leading to something. Hindi ba ginawa yun?
Your Honor, we will try to consider it. Ipaparating ko po ito sa mga pinuno po ng aming departamento. Ngunit sa kasalukuyan po, ang pinokus lang po ng aming task force ay ang magiging mga posibleng administrative liability ng ating butihing mayor mula sa Porak Pampang po man, Your Honor.
Sige, kasi nga siya na nagsalita mismo that is willing to open all his bank accounts and his property. So, try to maximize the willingness of the person to go and to undergo so many investigations. Oh, so isama niyo po 'yon, please.
Sige po, Your Honor. We will consider it.
Luis, now you have
Mr.
the floor again.
For us to have a foundation of the information on this allegation, may I respectfully move, Mr. Chair, that we invite Pyra Lucas and Toto Kausing to give us initial information, Mr. Chair, about the allegations which were mentioned by no less than Mayor Capil in his own letter.
So there's a motion to invite sino?
Pyra Lucas and Toto Kausing.
Pyra is a woman?
Yes.
Pyra Luca.
I suppose so, Mr. Chair.
Pyra Luca.
Lucas.
So, and also
Toto Kausing.
Mr. Toto Kausing.
The names are mentioned in the letter of Mayor Capil, Mr. Chair.
So there's a motion to invite those two personalities. Is there a second motion? There's a second motion. Is there any objection? Hearing none, the said motion is now approved. Go ahead.
Last question, Mr. Chair, is for PESA and PAGCOR. Before the pronouncement of the President about the total ban of all POGO operations in the Philippines, may I ask, what really is the policy? Who is or what or which agency has the issuing authority to POGO licensees? PESA first.
Good afternoon, Mr. Chairman. Good afternoon, and to the honorable members of this committee. I am Attorney Jenny Romero, the head of the Legal Department of PESA. And in behalf of our Director General Teresa Panga, we wish to really thank the committee for inviting us. Because this will be the forum, one of the fora probably, where we could clarify and correct the pervading information that PESA registers Philippine offshore gaming operators or POGOs. An information it appears to be believed, shared, and even common to the public, other government agencies, and various offices. Well, with due respect to our beloved USEC for PAOK, USEC Gilbert Cruz, the most recent of which, sir, is during the interview of a PAOK spokesperson, Dr. Wilson Casho, where he mentioned that PESA allowed these POGOs and PESA provided the licenses to these POGO operators. In this representation, we wish to clarify that those information or this statement even is erroneous, Your Honors. With the kind indulgence of the Honorable Chairpersons and the Honorable Members of this committee, please allow us to provide accurate information regarding PESA in relation to POGOs. PESA's mandate under its charter, Republic Act 7916.
Mr. Chair, can we direct our resource speaker to just answer the question?
Yeah.
Whether okay. PESA has authority to issue license to POGOs?
Okay, thank you, Madam Chair. PESA is not mandated. It has no authority at all under its charter, 7916, RA 7916, to issue licenses to POGOs. In fact, it has been the long-standing policy of PEZA not to register online gaming, gambling, and although we have IT companies, these IT companies registered with PEZA are prohibited from engaging in online gaming, gambling, or any ancillary gaming activities. In fact, the registration agreement with PEZA prohibits them from doing so, Your Honors.
So Mr. Chair, may I know if the resource speaker is aware of RA 11590, Section 22?
Please reply. Are you aware?
This is the definition of offshore gaming licensee.
I am not aware of the specific provision, Madam Chair, but if it's okay that it could be read to me, then I would be very happy.
Mr. Chair, I wish to read the definition of offshore gaming licensee as provided in RA 11590, Section 22. It refers to the offshore gaming operator, whether organized abroad or in the Philippines, duly licensed and authorized through a gaming license by the Philippine Amusement Gaming Corporation or any special economic zone authority or tourism zone authority or freeport authority to conduct offshore gaming operations, including the acceptance of bets from offshore customers as provided for in their respective charters. In other words, Mr. Chair, it is recognized in this provision that apart from PAGCOR, there are three other establishments which were given the authority to issue license. One is a Special Economic Zone Authority, second is Tourism Zone Authority, and third is Freeport Authority, Mr. Chair. Can we be enlightened by PEZA?
Okay. Madam Chair, the PEZA has its own PEZA charter that is under RA 7916 as amended. And in the provisions of the charter, we don't have any mandate or authority to issue licensing or even authority for these gaming operators, Your Honor.
So there's no provision in your charter?
None, Your Honor. In fact, as I said...
Do you have a copy of your charter right now? Can you kindly give it to us? Kasi, well, it is in conflict with the...
I have a copy of our charter here, Your Honor.
Kindly give it to us right now.
Yes, sir.
Because what the good Congresswoman is mentioning, it was mentioned on the provision of... the different economic zones, including yours. Pero sa inyo, wala naman, no?
Wala naman, Your Honor. In fact, as I said, it has been a long-standing policy of PEZA not to register gaming operations because we recognize the authority of the PAGCOR to do that.
Okay. Congresswoman Luistro, here, you try to check the charter of the PEZA.
Yes. May we confirm from PEZA if they have the power to regulate this Special Economic Zone Authority, Tourism Zone Authority, and Freeport Authority?
Please reply.
Does PEZA have the power to regulate?
Please reply.
Mr. Chair, yes. There is this misconception that all economic zones are under the supervision of PEZA. It is not true. PEZA is a separate and an independent authority, which is separate from the other investment promotion agencies. We call them IPAs. These are the likes of BCDA, SBMA, AFAB, APECO, CESA. What else? They have their own charters. They are created under a separate law. And they are distinct from PEZA and they are outside the supervision of PEZA, Your Honor.
And so, Mr. Chair, I understand that they have no power to regulate, as mentioned. And it appears that this Economic Zone Authority have autonomy once they are given their own charter. But can you please explain, PEZA? There is a provision here, notwithstanding any law to the contrary. No offshore gaming license shall hereinafter be issued by the Aurora Pacific Economic Zone and Freeport Authority. Why all of a sudden this was singled out?
Madam Chair, I I'm sorry, but I did not get the drift of the question. But as I said a while ago, PEZA is a different authority from the other investment promotion agencies. One of them is Cavite Economic Zone, APECO or Aurora, SBMA, BCDA. They are different from us, Your Honor.
I understand, Mr. Chair, but I wish to invite the attention of our resource speaker to RA 11590, Section 22. This is the definition of offshore gaming licensee. Meron pong portion dito after that definition, notwithstanding any law to the contrary, no offshore gaming license shall hereinafter be issued by Aurora Pacific Economic Zone and Freeport Authority.
That will be your last question, Congresswoman Luistra.
Yes, Mr. Chair. Curious lang po ako. While we recognize the authority of the other economic zones authority, bakit pagdating po dito sa Aurora Pacific Economic Zone, biglang na-single out siya at bawal siyang mag-issue ng license?
Your Honor, I don't think that that could be answered by PEZA because that is not a law being administered by PEZA. As I said, APECO is a different authority. It has its own charter, Your Honor. And they are not under our supervision or authority.
Do we have any resource speaker who can enlighten us on this, Mr. Chair? Nagtataka lang po ako kung bakit dito mismo sa substantive law, biglang na-single out itong isang economic zone authority that they're being prohibited from issuing an offshore gaming license.
That's it? Okay, the next interpellator will be Congressman Chairman Akop. Sir, you are recognized.
May katanungan pa na hindi nasasagot yung aking katabi, Mr. Chair.
Mr. Chair, so, I am asking if there's any resource speaker who can enlighten us on this.
I'm sorry, I was not able to hear that because Congressman Kit Flores is trying to whisper a lot of things in my ear. Okay, who want to answer the query of Congresswoman Luistro?
Maybe the PAGCOR is aware?
Mr. Chair, I think PAGCOR could be one.
PAGCOR. And I would like to remind the members that we have invited as well our former PAGCOR, Andrea Domingo, Mr. Dennis Cunanan, PSA, and LRA. Yun na lang mga hindi natin natatanong. Anyway, so...
Mr. Chair, since no question has been propounded already to Commissioner Domingo, perhaps let us hear from her. Maybe she can enlighten us on this kung bakit na-single out yung Aurora.
Ano ba yan? Issuance ba yan ng PAGCOR?
Yes. Issuance of... offshore gaming license.
Issuance of?
Offshore gaming license. POGO license.
Oh, this is PAGCOR yan. And that was the year what?
I suppose that this is during the time of the previous administration, Mr. Chair.
Oh, so saktong-sakto si former PAGCOR Chairman Andrea Domingo. Ma'am, you are now recognized. Thank you so much.
Chairman. Pwede ko pong itanong kung kasama po ba ito nung sinasabi niyong Republic Act?
Can you please help the former chairman to
11590,
please?
Mr. Chair, it's RA 11590.
Kung batas yan ay hindi po alam ng PAGCOR, siguro po mas mabuti para masagot natin yung katanungan ng ating congresswoman, tumingin po dun sa minutes ng meeting ng mga deliberations para po malaman kung bakit yung nag-enact ng law ay hindi isinama ang APECO dun sa pwedeng mag-issue ng licenses. Hindi ko po kasi alam yan at ang PAGCOR po talaga pong nire-recognize yung power authority of the reports at saka mga eco zones na nandun sa kanilang charter na pwede silang mag-issue pero nga ho, dinefine ng Executive Order 13 na dun lang sa jurisdictional area nila po.
Maybe the good agency that can answer on this query of Congresswoman Luistro is the BIR. Kasi parang taxation to eh, di ba? Right? Correct. Congressman Akop, you want to say something? Because, ano to eh, amendment ng ano? Yes, National Internal Revenue Code of 1997.
Mr. Chair, for the information of the committee, this is the Act Taxing POGOs. RA 11590.
So, the best The best personalities who can answer this
is Pagkor.
No.
D-I-R.
The one who drafted and crafted the law. And that is the tayo to. House of Representatives.
Mr. Chair.
And I think Chairman Domingo is right that we need to check the minutes who is sponsored and putting in the provision that statement, no? Particularly on that Aurora,
Mr. Chair,
Aurora something, di ba? So basically, it was crafted by the House of Representatives and the House and the Senate of the Philippines. So basically, doon natin makikita yun sa minutes.
Mr. Chair, from the BIR.
Yes, the chair would like to acknowledge the presence of Congressman Ramon Rodrigo Gutierrez and Congressman Chino Almario. So, Attorney Tibayan, you wanted to say something?
Mr. Chair,
and Congressman Franz Pumaren.
Ma'am, sorry, Mr. Chair, if I remember correctly, during the deliberations before...
Go ahead, you're recognized. Go ahead, we are listening.
Because I was also part of the ones helping time na dinideliberate sa Senate. I think the law was basically patterned from PAGCOR's setup. So, and then I think at the time, just different like PESA, CESA, they were involved because they had had licensees at the time, but I think that's why APECO was not involved kasi parang lumalabas ba wala ata silang licensee. So they did not ask to be included yata, Mr. Chair, if I remember correctly.
You want to ask that directly, Congressman Barbers?
Yes, thank you, Mr. Chair. Just a short question in relation to your question. Tanong ko lang, kung kasi wala sa charter ng APECO that they will allow operations of online gaming, correct? Who's that gentleman who was answering earlier?
Okay, si Attorney from BIR. But before I recognize you again, I would like to acknowledge the presence of the beautiful Congresswoman from PBA Party List, Margarita Ignacia Nograles. Migs, okay, go ahead, sir. Attorney, you can reply, please.
As to the charter, Mr. Chair, I'm not privy po. I'm not aware po. But I just remember at the time, APECO did not have licenses, kaya hindi lang sila sinama during the deliberations sa Senate po.
But there was a POGO operation in APECO. Kaya nga.
No.
Who issued that license to that POGO?
Congressman, I wanted to be clarified as well. So, medyo hindi ko masyado naintindihan yun. So, it was included in that Republic Act, but prior to that, there was an operation.
Yes. That is the logical conclusion, Mr. Chair.
So,
the reason why it was prohibited in 11590.
Yes, correct.
Ibig sabihin, there was an operation, kaya prohibit dun sa 11590. I understand that the law should not be discriminatory. Bakit biglang in-isolate, discriminate yung isang yun?
I think the best thing for us to do is try to find out the minutes of that discussion because the BIR himself is not sure, no, what really transpired during the deliberation. So basically, we cannot answer that right now. So let us wait for a little bit longer. Maybe a week from now, we'll be asking and tasking the COMSEC to find out the minutes of that deliberation of that Republic Act, what? 811590, for us to find out sino yung naglagay doon sa provision na yun. Okay.